great gentleman, so we're going to bring him up for it. Can we bring him up for a couple of minutes? You get ready, McCormick. You get ready. I'll get you up here. The world will see a vibrant Republican.
That right there was a newly released video showing a different angle of Thomas Matthew Crooks on the roof just minutes before he opened fire on Donald Trump at his rally on July 13th in Butler, Pennsylvania. The video was released by James Copenhaver, one of the victims of the shooting, who was critically injured. Donald Trump has actually now returned to Pennsylvania for the first time since he narrowly avoided a fatal shot. And he says he plans to return to Butler.
People said to me, are you serious? I said, I'm serious. We're going back. It's a great place. 18 days ago, where we had a very terrible day, we had a rough day, I will tell you, by all accounts. I should not be with you today. I shouldn't be with you.
Welcome to Mad World, our weekly culture wars wrap-up. Let's get into it. Well, it's a busy week for US politics, with both Donald Trump and Kamala Harris out and about campaigning and blasting each other. Former President Trump travelled to Harrisburg in Pennsylvania for a rally, and it didn't take long for him to take a swipe at his former opponent, President Joe Biden.
Remember when Biden used... I used to love this guy, because you were on pins and needles watching him speak. You know, when's he going to blow it? And it would always happen. Remember, he'd finish the speech and he couldn't find the stair. Go. And then these handsome men would run up and grab him and help him. And every time I imitate it, the First Lady tells me, why do you keep doing that? Because they keep saying you can't find the stairs off the podium. You know, you've only got about 9 stairways off the podium.
But Donald Trump's main target was, of course, his political rival, Kamala Harris, the Democrats' presumptive nominee for November's election. He says he's ready to take her on.
Kamala Harris bragged that, quote, I will proudly put my record against Donald Trump's any day of the week. I will put it against Donald Trump. This got one of the worst records in anywhere. Well, Kamala, let's go. Challenge accepted. Are you ready? Let's compare our record point by point.
And here he goes again.
The contrast could not be more stark. On the one hand, you have a radical left puppet candidate who is fake. And on the other hand, you have a president who will fight for America.
After days of Americans wondering if or when Barack and Michelle Obama would endorse Kamala Harris for the presidency, after Joe Biden had officially withdrawn from his re-election bid, the two finally called the VP, offering their support. While the delay had Republicans questioning the legitimacy of the endorsement, VP Harris released this promotional video for it.
Kamala!
Hi.
Hey there.
Aw, hi, you're both together. Oh, it's good to hear you both.
I can't have this phone call without saying to my girl Kamala, I am proud of you. This is going to be historic.
We called to say Michelle and I couldn't be prouder to endorse you and to do everything we can to get you through this election and into the Oval Office.
But this prompted Donald Trump to mock that video at his rally.
Because everything about Kamala Harris rollout, it's phony and it's fake. Did you see when President Obama and Michelle called? Did you see? Hello? Hello? Yes. Yes. Who is this? Oh, this is Michelle and Barack. Oh. So surprised to hear. They got 4 cameras in front. Oh, I'm so surprised. It's on speakerphone. Listen, we just want to congratulate you on destroying Joe Biden. I mean, on the winning the... Hey, is Joe Biden going to... Was that the phoniest phone call you've ever seen?
But Kamala Harris had her own swipes for Donald Trump, blasting the former president at her rally in Atlanta.
Donald Trump, on the other hand, has been talking a big game about securing our border, but he does not walk the walk. Or as my friend Quavo would say, he does not walk it like he talks it.
But Kamala Harris is back at claiming Donald Trump, if elected, would pass a nationwide abortion ban.
And now he intends to pass a nationwide abortion ban to ban access to fundamental health care in every state.
But Donald Trump has repeatedly claimed that he would not sign any bill banning abortion nationwide if he were to become president again. That prompted various social media users on X to call the VP a liar. As the campaign for the election heats up, both Republicans and Democrats have been taking their swipes at each other. One of the main criticisms of Kamala Harris, though, is her approach to handling the border crisis, as she was named the border czar in the Biden administration. It's no secret that Border Patrol agents have been run off their feet in the last few years as mass influxes of migrants illegally enter the country at various points across the border states, California, New Mexico, Arizona, and Texas. So when Kamala Harris's team posted this video, it was met with criticism.
On the border, the choice is simple. Kamala Harris supports increasing the number of Border Patrol agents. Donald Trump blocked a bill to increase the number of Border Patrol agents. Kamala Harris supports investing in new technology to block fentanyl from entering the country. Donald Trump blocked funding for technology to block fentanyl from entering the country. Kamala Harris supports spending more money to stop human traffickers. Donald Trump blocked money to stop human traffickers.
Because in 2018, Kamala Harris was among the dozens of Democrats signing a letter to fellow senators to reject Donald Trump's border proposal, which of course asked for more funding to build the border wall, but also asked for more funding to invest in increasing the number of Border Patrol agents. Ex-owner Elon Musk has weighed in on a bizarre situation taking place on Google. An ex-user posted a video where they showed how Googling Donald Trump directly leads to articles about Kamala Harris. Elon Musk responded to the post and wrote, "Wow, this is crazy." And finally, when the Olympics opening ceremony aired last week, the theatrical performance was met with serious backlash, as many perceived it as mocking Leonardo da Vinci's The Last Supper portrait. While some believed it was inclusive, others felt it mocked Christian faith. The Paris Olympics Committee apologised for any offence taken, but claimed it was an interpretation of the Greek god Dionysus. But what has since gone viral is Donna Kelsey, the mother of American footballers Travis and Jason, weighing in on the backlash. She posted on Facebook writing, "This is what happens when you ban books and limit education. The opening ceremony of the Olympics wasn't a mock of the Last Supper. If you have any knowledge of the Greek origin of the Olympics and the French's rich history of theatre, you would have gotten this. However, because of your veiled homophobia, some of you can't discern factual information."